Reload! It's on! Thank you. unknown vessel. Prepare to submit to...
Wait! I know him! He's the one that helped on Altair 2. This is Captain Myung. Please acknowledge. Come on, nice to see you. Been busy risking your ass for total strangers, huh? Then I hope the UC's always got enough credits for you. Do I have to? Fine. Private Sai says hi. No more passing messages. Decorum, Marines. So, Command signed off on our unauthorized training mission. Sadly, lost some men, but training accidents happen to the best of us. Captain Torres got promoted. Sent us a goodie basket. Most of it was confiscated by customs. But there was a keg of good Aquila City beer. We raised a glass in his honor. Actually, more than one. I stand by it. You'd make a hell of a Marine. But, damn proud to know you too. Command's shipping us off to parts unknown. But would you accept a final parting gift? It's a nice thought, but the galaxy's a big place. A lot of good people owe you their lives. Maybe one day, some of us can return the favor. Myung out.
Surviving being attacked, causing trouble. Isn't that just fighting back? Hey, pilot, could you move your arm a little bit to the left? I can't make out the console.
Don't move! He's trying to figure out our destination, probably transmitting this conversation right now while we're still in orbit.
Well, yeah, thought I was making that pretty obvious. Okay, okay, put the gun down. I'm done. See? My retinas are pointing away from the console and towards this lovely view of space we have out the window.
Tie him up. Once we get back to the base, the fun starts.
guarantee the UC will be there for you next time.
Welcome back.
How can I be of service? Understood, Captain.
Thank you. no certainty to the universe at all. Once you really start getting out there, the laws of physics kind of turn into suggestions.
You're pulling my leg again, right? No exaggerations this time.
Hey, unicorn. Not kidding.
What? The mythical mare with the magic horn thing? Come on. Was King Arthur riding on it too?
Okay, it was more of an extremophile in the vague shape of a horse. But my point still stands. You need an open mind out there. You go into the far reaches of space too tightly wound, your brain is just gonna pop like a soda can. Say I feel too bad about you killing someone who kidnapped me and probably murdered a lot of people, but... honestly, I was kind of rolling the dice with you. But hey, sometimes a bet pays off. Hey, you're underselling my harrowing escape from certain doom here. A little charm goes a long way when the knives are out. Matsur the Grim? Honestly, a pretty nice guy as far as pirates go. Think I butted heads with his mentor once years back. Had the same kind of surprisingly hospitable vibe.
Depends on the question, but I'll give it my best shot.
I think about it a lot. There's so many possibilities. Some wonderful, some terrifying. I'm not a fearful man, but I am just a man. And I'm keenly aware that this artifact could change my life. Or end it. On Bendy? No, wait. It was Kazal. I can feel Lin's admonishing stare boring a hole in my back. She's not actually standing behind me, is she? Well, point is, my story's probably a lot like yours. We dug a pit, found some really wonky readings, and followed them to the artifact. I think it's pretty clear now there's a possible correlation between the visions and the powers. Of course, correlation isn't necessarily causation. Once is a fluke, twice is a coincidence, and so forth. But once I get back into academic mode, I'll be writing a paper that will suggest the connection is valid. Obfuscating the identities of the pirate, of course. Which means we all get code names. Fun, right? Well, when I picked it up, I had no idea what it was. I knew it was something spectacular, though. I saw a vision. Flashing lights, the whole shebang.
Sure. Like what?
Always a pleasure.
Well, well, well. Look what the cat dragged in.